Hello, friends. My name's Alyssa, and I'm the Science Program Manager at Boston Children's Museum. And today, I'm going to show you how to make a battery out of pennies. Here's the things you'll need for today's project. First, 5 pennies. You'll need vinegar and a small jar or container to pour it into. LED light bulbs, some cardboard or mat board, a marker, and a pair of scissors. And some sandpaper. Or, if you're a grown-up, has a tool like this one, that makes the process a little easier. You might also want a paper towel or a rag like this one. The hardest part of this whole experiment is preparing the pennies. Pennies made after 1982 are mostly made of zinc and then covered in copper. Use your sandpaper or rotary tool to remove all of the copper from one side of 4 of your pennies. Next, use your marker to trace a penny to make 4 cardboard discs that are each just a little bit bigger than a penny. Now it's time to build your battery. You've got your 4 pennies that you've sanded down to zinc on one side, and 1 penny that you haven't done anything to. Pour some vinegar into your small container. Take your discs of cardboard and drop them in, and stir them around a little bit. Take your cardboard discs out of the vinegar and give them a little shape or a little pad so they're not completely soaked. Now, build your battery. The order of things is very important, so watch carefully. Place your first penny with the copper side down and the zinc side up. Then, add a cardboard disc. Place the next penny, copper down, zinc up, and add a cardboard disc. Keep going that way. And when you get to the top, add the penny that you didn't do anything to. Pick up your battery, and you want to make sure that none of the cardboard discs are touching each other, and that none of the pennies are touching each other. Now take a look at your LED. You'll notice that it's got 2 lines coming off of it, and one is just a little bit longer than the other. That is the positive lead. I always just remember that positive sounds like more, and more or longer, so the longer one is the positive lead. Place your positive lead on the top of the battery, on the penny that you didn't touch, and then touch the negative lead to the other penny. And there we go. Now let's take a look at some troubleshooting. That means figuring out what's going on if something's not working for you. There's a few things that might be going wrong. The first thing is, if you've got your LED backwards, like I said, the positive lead goes on the regular penny, and the negative lead goes on the bottom penny. If you've got that backwards, it won't work. Another thing is to, like I said, make sure that your cardboard pieces aren't touching each other around the pennies. Electricity is lazy and it will always take the shortest route it can. So if it can go straight through from one cardboard to the next without dealing with the penny, that's what it will do. And same for making sure that none of your pennies are touching each other. You also want to make sure that your LEDs work. Get out a simple coin battery like this and check your LED on the battery. Yep, this one works. Takes a bit of a fine touch to get it to work, but it will. Now, some LEDs in different colors need different amounts of power. Depending on the kind of LED you're using, you may find that the red one will work on your penny battery, but a blue one won't. Sometimes different colors need more electricity than others. If your LED isn't lighting up, and it's the colored kind, try adding a little more juice. And to do that, just add another layer of vinegar-soaked cardboard and another stripped penny. These aren't the only things that can possibly go wrong with your experiment. If you're still having trouble, go through the list of directions again from the very beginning and make sure that everything is as it should be. I hope you had fun making a penny battery today. Keep checking back on Facebook, Instagram, and YouTube for more experiments that you can try in your home. Thanks for joining me today, and I'll see you next time. If you liked this video, don't forget to follow us on YouTube. Just click on the red button.